You've won the project and now it's time to select those cables using, of course, AS3008. So how much does the mode of installation actually play in the ability of the cable to dissipate heat? Let's find out. Hi everyone from our new studio that we've just set up. So a few teething problems. And our first presentation is on cable current carrying capacity, which leads on from our previous presentation. And this time we're looking in more detail concerning the method of installation. But more specifically, how you install the cable can play a big role in your final selection process. Now, if you like what you see with these videos and you want us to make more of them, hit that subscription button. Tell your friends, get them to hit the subscription button as well. Let's get stuck into it. This presentation leads on from our cable derating presentation, where we looked at the various factors when it comes to selecting and assessing what cables are needed from a current carrying perspective. That's a bit of a mouthful. And how location and method of installation plays a huge role. Now we delve deeper into this area and look at the actual differences between the cables and the variations. Remember, with all electrical standards, there is a shall and should component, but it seems with AS3008, it is all shall. In this presentation, we are going to look again at the actual case study of a 300 kilowatt system. So what inverters are being used on this site? Inverter number one is a 100 kilowatt inverter. Inverter number two is another 100 kilowatt inverter. Number three is a 29.9 kilowatt inverter. That's precise. And number four is a 40 kilowatt inverter. So what current are we talking about? Combined current of 409.77 amps. In most cases, when people are installing inverters and connecting to a PVDB, they're invariably using a system where cable tray is used to accommodate the cables and then lid is put on. And that method is known as a wiring enclosure enclosed, and the ability of the cables to dissipate heat is considerably less than, say, in a cable ladder situation, going from the PVDB to the main switchboard without lid and the cables not touching. And it's incredible the amount of difference between the cable ratings between the different methods of installation. We know that when we compare aluminium to copper, that for the same size cable, copper has a greater current rating, even though per weight, aluminium is a better conductor. If we look at the different insulation types, thermoplastic versus XLPE 90 degree, we see variations in CCC. In addition, there are differences between multicore and single core, and further in the case of copper, flexible versus solid stranded. And how the cable is installed and in what plays a massive role, and the proximity to other cables, circuits, etc. And the list goes on. So how big are these actual differences? Let's first look at the difference between aluminium and copper. As an example, we will look at 35 mil cable, copper, solid stranded, and aluminium. XLP 90 degree. And the installation method is wiring enclosure in air enclosed. That's straight from AS3008. So the aluminium XLP 90 degree four core and earth wiring enclosure in air enclosed is 88 amps. That's its continuous current rating. Now the copper version has 114 amps. So you can see the difference is considerable. Now, the most common method of installing cable between the inverter and the PVDB is effectively wire enclosure in air enclosed. And it's in perforated tray against the wall with lid. There is a substantial difference between the two, and in the case of the 44 kVA inverter we have referenced, it requires a current of 63.51 amps. That's what it needs to get out of the cable. So we checked table 14, ACE 3008, column 11. 35 mil square, multi XLPE, 90 degree, will do 114 amps. But if we derate by 0.65, it gives you 74.1 amps. And we're doing that because the other inverters are classed as individual circuits. Now the aluminium version, we derate by the same factor, so it gives us 57.2 amps. So we can't use the 35 mil aluminium. We'd have to go to 50 mil because 52.2 amps is less than the required 63.51 amps. Can we still use 35 aluminium in this case? In other words, can we use single core XLPE? Aluminium XLPE 90 degree, this time single core, wiring enclosure and air enclosure, 93 amps times 0.65 equals 60.4 amps. We're close, but no cigar. And this comes from table 8, column 17, AS 3008. Now, what if we change the install method slightly? In many cases, tray lid is used for aesthetics, but if the inverters and PVDB are in an authorized area, it may be an option to install a perforated tray on the wall using single core aluminium with no tray lid. If we look at AS 3008, table 8, column 7, unenclosed, spaced from the surface, we see the CCC of 35 mil squared aluminium single core XLPE 90 degree, gee, it's a mouthful, cable is 119 amps. Now, if we look at clause 3.5.2.2, it says the derating factors of table 22 to 26 are not applicable to the following conditions of group cables. See part of Fig 1 below. The reality is we can use aluminium XLPE single core 35 mil cable now because we changed the method of install from a fully enclosed tray affixed to the wall with lid to tray slightly off the wall with no lid. In fact, if we look at table 8, column 7, we can see we can even possibly use 25 mil squared from a current carrying capacity perspective, 97 amps. Obviously, we have to also calculate the voltage rise, and this may result in having to use a larger capacity cable or swap to copper. So we now see how important it is to really assess the situation completely. Material cost, installation cost ratio. This is the question. From an installation point of view, installing cable tray without lid takes less time and material, but we know we have to use extra components to space the tray from the wall. Now, using multicore with the 4x inverters under consideration, install time is less as there are less cables than using a single core option. And what about the cost of the different cables under consideration? It's a question of material install cost ratios. Does the extra install time potentially offset the gains from using smaller diameter, cheaper cable? Also, if using aluminium, there are specific cable lug requirements, etc. So you can see the cable and method of installation, aluminium, four core and earth, wiring enclosure and air enclosed. Cable current cable for 44kV inverter, single core, derated. Cable current table for 44 kVA inverter, 4-core on earth, no derating. Cable current table for 44 kVA inverters, single core, no derate at all. So, what multi-cable can we use for the 44 kVA inverter? What single-core cable can we use for the 44 kVA inverter? So it can be seen that the amount of copper or aluminium material can be reduced considerably if the method of installation is more conducive to heat dissipation, as this is what determines the CCC of the cable in question. We have seen that if the installation is in perforated enclosed tray direct on the wall, not only do we require a thicker cable, but also we have to derate the cable as well. As in this example, there are four circuits, read inverters, so derating is required. So from 16 mil squared copper XLPE 90 degree single core solid touching unenclosed at 86 amps to the best case to 35 mil squared copper XLPE 90 degree 4-core on earth flexible wiring enclosure in air enclosed 111 amps rated to 72.5, that's the range. The reality is that if the cable runs from inverters to PVDB are fairly short, the cost savings may be negligible if selecting an unenclosed cable option if allowed. But if the runs are long, real savings can be made with the run between the PVDB to the DB or the MSB. Note, even though the cable may satisfy the current carrying capacity, there is still volt rise considerations that may be taken into account. Conclusion. The whole area of cable selection according to AS3008 is a complicated one. Correctly assessing what installation options are available may save the installer a considerable amount of money, but of course this may be tempered by the material install cost ratio and the overall amount of money spent to design, supply and install cable that satisfies the standards CCC and V-Rise. Good luck on your next project.
Thanks so much for watching our presentation on cables and installation methods. I'm Veli from Greenwood. If you have any questions, any inquiries, any answers, feel free to drop us a line. And if you like what you see and you want us to make more of these videos, hit that subscription button. And if I've made any mistakes, please tell me as well. See you next time.